don't mind the washing machine going on in the background, but lately I have an obsession with porridge. So I've been using the Quaker oat sachets, so I've just put in some of the oats and, well, all of the oats in there into a bowl, and then I use lactose free milk. Even lying when I say I never do this. So as soon as I want to film making my porridge for a video, I've made an absolute mess. I've spilt the milk, but this is very not aesthetically pleasing. This is just real life. So I've spilt the milk. So I'm gonna include that in the video because this is life. So I'm just gonna obviously stir that. Made a fine mess. And then I put this in the microwave for about a minute 30. I've got 800 watts. So I'm going to pop that in for a minute 30. Judge it. Watch it like orc, because it just goes over otherwise, doesn't it? There we go. Minute 30. Start. There we go. And I'm going to clean this mess up in the meantime. It's a little bit thick in consistency, so I'm just going to add a little bit more milk. Hopefully not make a mess this time. I did clear up with my method cleaner, just in case you're interested. So I'm just going to add a little drop of that and then mix it round. It's so hard to film and make food at the same time. So it's still quite a bit thick, but it's okay. And then I'm going to show you what I'm going to put on top of this. Raspberries. Have I even opened this yet? No, I haven't. Oh god, this could be a challenge. Right, I'm popping some raspberries down on my porridge. I absolutely have an obsession with raspberries at the minute. So there we go, save some for my boyfriend. I'm gonna switch the kettle down, have another cup of tea. It'll be my second one of the day. Why is that strap doing that? Ugh. And then some of this Sweet Freedom Choc Shop Brownie. So I'm gonna drizzle some of that on the top, chocolate and raspberries. Yum, yum, yum. What is going on with me today? I just cannot do anything. I cannot function, clearly. But yeah. Voila, bon appetit. This is my brekkie first. Zoom into that. Is it gonna focus? Oh, lovely, beautiful. Use the rest of that wipe to clean up that bit of chocolate that I've just spilt everywhere, honestly. Thank you. Et voila, cup of tea, porridge oats with fresh raspberries and a Sweet Freedom Choc Shop drizzle on the top. Delish.
So it is in fact a few days later, after that disaster of breakfast that I showed you, where I just made a complete mess. I actually forgot to film the rest of my meals that day, which is bizarre, but I don't know how I managed to forget that I was filming what I eat in a day. But it's now a few days later. I am filming a few days later because I did actually have a gourd flare up, which wasn't very nice. So I wasn't really eating much. But I'm going to keep the breakfast in that I showed you where I had the porridge. That is one of the variations of porridge I have. If I don't have the chocolate with the raspberries or the strawberries, I normally have blueberries and a drizzle of honey on top, which is lovely. Another one I have, which I haven't had in a while, is chopped up apple pieces with cinnamon on top. But for my lunch today, I have been to the supermarket. I've been to Morrison's because Martin and I have friends coming around for dinner tonight. Martin is cooking his signature chicken and bacon pasta dish, which I'm really looking forward to because it is like one of my favourite dinners. But I've just obviously come back from the supermarket and I did actually meet my parents for a coffee, so I had a soy latte. I didn't have anything else to eat. I really wanted a cupcake, but they were like £2.50 each and they were uncovered, and I just thought it's a lot of money for a cupcake. Oh great, my battery's low on my camera. So I thought I'd just show you what I've got in Morrison's, in my B&M bag. But I'm going to show you my lunch. So I've got this to go because I need to get the flat sorted a bit before our friends come over. So I've got a tuna and cucumber baguette, just keeping it real. Probably not the healthiest of lunches, but when I saw that in the lunch fridge bit, I was like, I just need that in my life. It just sounded so fresh and delish. And then I'm probably going to have a packet of my Walker's oven baked crisps with it in cheese and onion because they're my favourite. But other shopping wise, I've got some rolls because we have Martin's mum and his little brother and sister coming over tomorrow for lunch and some games. I've got some cooked chicken to put in said rolls or for sandwiches in the week. Got Martin and myself a chocolate bar, so I've got Martin a Star bar and I got myself a Galaxy orange. I've not tried that yet. They were like £2 for a pound. Got some Brussels pate because I know that's quite popular as well, sandwiches and stuff. Got some beef stock pots because we're running low on those. Some garlic baguettes to go to dinner tonight. Honestly, I'm having so much bread today. Now this is like a realistic day, like it's a Saturday. So I'm eating a lot of bread today, which is not great, but I don't eat this much bread every single day, so it is balanced. But it's just one of those days today where most of my meal options contain bread or carbs. Got some scotch eggs, and then got a couple of sandwich fillers for like tomorrow or for like in the week to take to work. So we've got tuna crunch, which sounds lovely, and some egg mayonnaise. I do want to make my own egg mayonnaise, but it's a bit of a faff, isn't it? Martin has sugar in his tea, and for when guests come around, these are really good because they don't dry out. Obviously they can't, they're already cubed. So they are the Silver Spoon white sugar cubes. These are actually cheaper in Sainsbury's by 15 pence. So, but we needed them. I was in Morrison's. I can't be asked to go to Sainsbury's just for sugar cubes. Got a 4-pack of original cola cans for £2 on offer. That's for one of our friends who is the dedicated driver. I have got Coke Zero, but I know some people like the 4-pack version, so I've got that as backup really. Some onions because they are a massive kitchen staple. Some baked potatoes so if we want to make our own chips, have a jacket spud one evening, or just make some roasties ourselves. I need to get some duck fat actually because they're really crisp up nicely. Got half a cucumber for like salads and sandwiches. That will actually go nice with that tuna crunch. It'll kind of like mimic my tuna and cucumber baguette thing that I've got. And then the most important ingredient, because it's both our fault really, we both forgot to get the chicken out of the freezer last night to defrost. So we've got a 4-pack of chicken breast fillets. Oh my god. I couldn't get my words out. So that was the whole of our shopping. It comes to about £27, which don't actually know if that's good or bad. But I'm going to put my food shop away. You're currently bouncing on my spaghetti jar on the windowsill in the kitchen. So I'm going to put my shopping away. I've already washed my hands, but I might just wash them again where I've touched a chicken packet. I get a bit funny about things like that. And then I'll show you my lunch once it's on my plate. And then if I eat anything before dinner, which I probably won't because I'm going to want to save my appetite, I'll show you. And we do have pudding tonight as well. So today is a very, I don't want to say naughty, but it's a luscious day for food, shall we say. It's not all that healthy, but I might do a healthy day of like when I'm being proper good. So I'll show you my lunch in a sec.
Right, so this is my lunch. Didn't take much effort at all. So I've got my tuna cucumber baguette, a packet of Walker's oven baked, and I've also got some of this no added sugar cranberry juice drink, and that is from Sainsbury's. So yeah, that is my lunch. I will enjoy this, I know I will, and then if I have anything before dinner, which I don't think I will show you guys.
So I'm currently sitting down. I thought I'd try this on camera. This is weird filming myself eat, but there's a first for everything. Mmm. Be nice. So I'm just going to eat this and watch some YouTube. I just watched earlier Gemma Miles' gender reveal. She's having a boy. I really thought she was having a girl. I just don't really have a feeling, but she's having a boy, so that's cute. Sorry, talking my mouth all. It's not even a mukbang. No excuse. But yeah, I'm watching this girl called Courtney Alyssa. She's like a small YouTuber, but she's done quite well and she's got her own business. She's got her own like candle and wax melt business, which I have purchased from. Can confirm, very, very nice wax melts and great service, and they're good prices as well. So this is her channel. I'm just gonna watch her video she's done. She's just uploaded a video about how she got her first payment and starting a YouTube channel. So I'm gonna watch that, eat my lunch, and then get the flat ready for when our friends come over.
So we've mashed up two stock cubes with a bit of olive oil and some salt to form into a paste.
Mm-hmm.
Now we just use our hands to coat every single chunk of chicken.
So you're like marinating it?
Basically, yeah. Once that's all done, we'll then transfer it into a smaller bowl so it's ready to store in the fridge.
What, that little bowl there?
Yeah, ready to store in the fridge.
We've got our bacon ready to go.
Add it later, so it's really just going nice hot pan.
Lovely.
Garlic and olive oil.
And then we've got a breast left for tomorrow's dinner, which is chicken curry, so that'll be nice. Lovely. And then this all goes in the fridge until we're ready to cook it up.
Absolutely.
So you've got the mushrooms in the back. What's that? Is that the water for the pasta?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness!
Get out! Yes, I overcooked it.
So this is the chicken and bacon creamy pasta, and we've got mushrooms in ours, and our friends don't, they don't like mushrooms. And then we've got the very golden brown garlic baguettes. Yeah, this is looking lovely. It's got fresh parsley in there as well. So yum, yum, yum. That is dinner. Of what I eat in a day, this is my dinner.